Okay, getting Easter time on bunny rabbit. So as you can see, first step, mount him to the vise. Yeah, this is a 7-inch rabbit. They make a 9-inch rabbit, but this is our smaller one. As you see, we normally start out cutting between his ears there, getting that plug out of there, and all of a sudden he starts looking like a rabbit. Sitting there kind of drawing around his legs. Giving his toes. And then running around, finished taking out that plug that's on the back side of his head there. Kind of sticks down, comes down the back side of his neck, so there's a little bit of that plug behind his head you gotta take out. I mean, real beginner carvers probably have a little harder time seeing stuff, or, you know, and people that, you know, have done a couple, understand how they should look. When you're putting your whiskers on the side of your face there now, or ain't whiskers, it's long hair around the cheeks. Cheek hair, I guess you'd call it. Well, that's about all the furring I do to him, is just a little bit of long hair on his cheeks. And the rest of it, there's enough texture already in the carving that it looks pretty good. And that was it with the saw. Here we are with the angle grinder, just giving the base a good cleaning. Kind of cleaning up his ears there a little bit. I say most of you at good, better angle grinders are $80. Pop his eyes in. He's starting to wake up. Good nose. Yeah, just doing a little bit of nose work there again. Just got a little Dremel poke hole in his nose. Work on his mouth there a little bit. Give him his little mouth up underneath. Cleaning him up. Doing a little bit of touch up on some sharp corners and stuff that's sitting there. We're kind of softening them up, and then we'll get our flapper out. Then we get done with that. Give him a brush down. Okay, we're back to the nylon bristle brush. We'll wipe him down, and you see how much sawdust coming off of there. It works really good. We only have one rabbit. We sell them in two different sizes. We sell them in a 7-inch diameter and a 9-inch diameter. And a lot of the hand carvers out there, they get them confused with diameter and height. They think they're the height, but we sell by diameter, so you know, a lot of time they order one, they expecting a little bitty carving, and it's a lot bigger carving than they think. everything on our website is sold by diameter, not height. The diameter, when we make them, everything, you know, our wood, 6, 7, 8, 9 inches in diameter. So the height is dictated by the diameter, but our stock is in 6, 7, 8 inch diameter. We just giving them a light color, you know. Like I say, we're gonna be staining them here shortly, so you'll get a little better contrast on him then. We're gonna get our sander flex back a hold to him, flap him out and call him done. I thought we'd kind of go over the stuff that we use basically on coloring our carvings here. Our main things, I got some dyes here that I made by Mixall that you can mix with just about anything. I use basically water for the 90% of it. Mix, you know, the dye with water. It's real easy to keep clean in my airbrush. But what I probably use even more than the colors is Minwax stain. I like Golden Oak. It's probably my favorite light color. And then I use Ventional and Black Walnut for my dark colors. Minwax makes hundreds of different colors. I basically use 90% of what I do. And as far as airbrush system, I got cheap Harbor Freight airbrush, or you can get them on eBay. That's about what we use for coloring our carvings. Hope this helps. Hey, this is just kind of our down and dirty quickie job on a rabbit. We start out with our dark walnut again, just kind of spraying his ears, nose, any of the real dark areas up close. And once we get them laid down, we take back up away from it, fog it out a little bit, kind of give it a softer dark color, and do it around his legs and feet, and call it done. And hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thank you.